energies have been extreme in many ways, where the angels are showing me it's like a balloon that's been blown up by strong solar energies, more and more and more, a giant balloon. And a strong balloon, like stronger than the helium types, and it's been blown up to the fullest, where it feels like it's about to burst. And that's the message that came through this morning. The solar energies, which are strong, like solar flares and all the solar activity, the space weather, which has been really illuminated, it has come through so powerfully. And interestingly, being solar energy, it's strongly affected our solar plexus. So that is the energy center, the chakra around the stomach area. And a lot of people have been experiencing bloating. So if that is you, and maybe you just get that anyway, maybe you get IBS, maybe you get the empathic version, but pretty bad bloating. And so they ironically link the idea of a balloon blowing up with the stomach blowing up. And it's like you have all this air inside, or just stuff, because stuff is stuck that you've been processing, and you're processing it. And it's a lot, and it comes in this giant force, like a bloody smack in the face. And so when you go through periods like this, and it can be feel like it's relentless, maybe you've been extremely tired, restless nights, insomnia, pains in your body, neck pain is huge, other pains coming up, maybe in your back or your shoulders or wherever in your body, your legs, wherever it is for you. It might be random pains, like areas you haven't had before, or if you're like me, you have pre-existing conditions, they flare up. It could be really hard for people that usually go through chronic pain as it is, or if you're pretty good and you don't have those pains, when it comes up you're like, oh, what the hell is this now? The other one is headaches, a lot in the head, or like me, migraines. So you know, I've had a lot, like constantly, almost every day. It's been relentless, so it's been really hard. When you're like this, you're often forced to stop. For some people, maybe you've been able to get through, and you know, going to work and coming home, and you just feel like it's one big hard slog. And for others, it's like, I can't do this. So, you know, you need that time off. Or you're somewhere in between, where it's not exactly time off. It's this kind of mutant existence of kind of slogging, trying to get through and drag yourself, and then crashing to bed, or just being a bit irate, or whatever it is. These things can affect your moods, your mind can be working overtime, your anxiety can be raising up. And also, what you've heard for a really long time now from the spiritual community in different ways, or when certain energies come up, is all your stuff rises up, right? And it's not necessarily the usual reasons, such as, and it is a bit like the full moon, and yes, that's played a part as well, and you know, planetary movements changing, absolutely, yes, but this is also a new energy, and it's strong. It's like a full strength coffee, you know, triple espresso, and you're going to be affected by it. You can give some people a headache, right? And so the old stuff is rising up, or whatever it is, and it's uncomfortable. It is so uncomfortable. Maybe you're thinking, oh God, you know, I've already worked through this stuff, or not this again. And you know, you can't avoid it. You really can't. And so it rises up, and it's here for us to look at and work through and process and go the next level. And that word uncomfortable is really big, because as I say that, literally my solar plexus is clenching is reacting. It's really showing that, yes, we've got a lot accumulated, a lot that has affected our own sense of self-value has been coming up, our place in the world or just within our own, whatever it is, family, household, extended family, community, workplace, whatever it is for you personally. And also your sense of who you are, your sense of identity, being broken, being rearranged. The angels show me like now the old image that I've gotten before that you might have heard me say about jigsaw pieces. But they're rearranging to show a new picture, a new vista, because timelines are changing. That's also another huge topic that I'll be talking more about as time goes by. Changing face, who you are at face value. So really let these things sink in. Our identities, and it's such a huge thing because we've really got to get down to the nitty-gritty, to the basics, to reimagine if you came here on earth as a pure baby that you were and earth wasn't like it is, you would have had a totally different experience, right? And it would have been the most true experience that you could imagine. And your true self, your true being would have shined and radiated like the sun. So they're showing me that the sun is showing us who we really are. And that brings up so much pain because the world only mirrors to us something awful. There is so much pain in this world and it causes so many people anxiety, especially for us sensitives, but for, you know, everyone. We're all dealing with stuff. We've all got stuff. We all have to deal with people as well. And it's all just this one big toxic soup, right? And so the message coming through with the sun is that it is showing us who we are, or who we are being that is not us, or that is a result of other people, life experiences, the pain in the world, which is so strong and is so relentless. Hence the energies have felt relentless, right? Until we work through and then pick up the pieces and then start again in a sort of a new slate. And you know, there's a lot of unknown still, so I feel like more messages will come when the time is right and ready. But for now, just to know that everything's for a reason and this is a season we are going through, but it's an important one, right? No matter where you are in the world and what the season is, they show me it's like a summer because of the sun. But it feels like a winter. It feels like the opposite. And that's what it's all about. It's about opposites. It's about duality, which is a universal law that we can't escape from while we are here. So there is the up and the down, the light and the dark. And it can be difficult when the extreme is shown. So an extreme of so much light brings up an extreme of so much darkness within ourselves, of our own personal stuff. And so you see it in a new way, and that's hurtful, and that's why working through it will bring you to another level or vista or view, like a new mountain view of your stuff. And it will allow you to work through it in a way where you can climb that mountain even further. But for now, it just feels like a lot. And of course, as I always say, it's different for everybody, depending where you are in your own personal evolution right now. But not only is it our own stuff that we're working through, but it's also the collective stuff. As we each work on our stuff, or stuff comes up, we're also working through everyone else's stuff because we are part of the all. It's that hive mentality, or the hive exists and we are within that hive. And unfortunately, the hive has become a matrix. Right, that's a whole other topic I want to talk about too. We are in a matrix, and you can see that in whatever way, shape or form you like, but it is a matrix of some level. Our world has been, you know, overtaken by some mean evil bees, right? You know, so that's a lot. Never underestimate how much we are going through, how much others are going through it too. And if you're a sensitive, you're an empath, you're a soul seeker, you're an old soul, you know, it's a lot. It's a lot for everyone anyway, but so many people are walking around oblivious and just, you know, who are not on the path consciously. And we have to be around this, and that can be hard, and it can be confrontational. It can make us feel pretty much sometimes like a piece of shit, right? Or just like it's all too much. And at other times, we deal with it better. And maybe right now, you're one of the people who, no, you're on the other side of this, and that is awesome. Because that's a beautiful place to be. So today I'm more speaking to the ones who are going through it. Because it's not easy, but you can get there. And believe you me, it is so much more helpful knowing that others are going through this too. So for example, in my Facebook group, and the link is below if you'd like to join it. And please do, you're very, very welcome. It's a place, you know, to be and to be able to speak about this stuff and feel like others go through this too. But for example, someone posted, you know, thanks so much for posting this, or because, you know, you feel like it's just me, right? And it's funny because it's a reciprocating, because I go through this stuff too. So that helps me as well, because I can feel like I'm going insane, right? But underneath it all, I know that something is moving through us. So think of it as a giant wave moving through you, like you're in the ocean and you have to run with this wave, right? You can't fight against it or you will friggin' drown. So the best thing to do, like when a big wave comes, or this and relentless, you know, when you've been bombed by relentless waves and you just got to gasp up for air wherever you can get it, right? That's what it feels like too when things are intense. So keep this in mind for future as well. All you got to do is find your way to exist and survive while you're thrashed around by these waves, right? And eventually you'll catch a break between waves and you'll be able to ride your way back to shore, and the sun will be brighter and you dry yourself off like a dog that comes out of the ocean and shakes all that water off, which is actually a message that I've received in the past for dealing with energy. Be like a dog that shakes it off, right? That's literally the image that I got. You know, because we all go through this stuff. It's like going out for a walk and then you get bummed in some kind of a rainstorm, and, you know, or when you're out on a boat and you deal with it and you get through and you come back and then you make yourself a cup of tea and eventually it's all okay again. However, the difference is from before is that not only will it be okay again, but it will be friggin' amazing. It will be so brilliant, so next level. But having said that, it's not necessarily like that too, because the world is not... So in one way, it is changing at accelerated speeds. And in another, it feels like a drawn out long process when you're on the conscious path, because you feel through it all so much and you so want it to be the utopia, right? For so long, especially when you have these moments of awakening, and maybe you've experienced this even, you know, 10, 20 years ago, where you want it to be the utopia because that's what you know to be true, because that's where you're from. That's your divine origin, your knowing of that there's something so much more beautiful than this. is what makes it so difficult. So we're not going to go from how things have been on Earth instantly to that sunny rainbow other side. We're just in a process of getting there, but the energy that comes in that is strong is kind of like makes it difficult, but it gives us a boost to the next level and the next new spot. You know, like I've been saying it for years, bit by bit, that you know, we go step by step, two forward, one back, and all that kind of thing. Or sometimes it feels like one forward and friggin' 20,000 steps back, then you got to crawl your way back, right? So just know that you're not alone in this. And I am out for a walk, so sorry, I'm huffing and puffing a little bit, and because you know, I've been couch bound for like 2 weeks, it's just been relentless. So going for one little walk now is like, I feel so unfit. But it's so nice. It's so nice too. I did feel a bit of a turn in the energy today. My neck still feels uncomfortable, but it's way better than other days. So for now, it's okay. It's so nice to be outside and just absorbing the light of the sun, but it is nurturing, it's healing, it's warming, it's elucidating, right? It's illuminating, and it illuminates the consciousness, and it is further awakening us up to who we really are and who we came here and are meant to be. But it's all okay because we're all just exactly where we need to be. So you just be kind to yourself, and when you're on the other side of this, you will know it. So I think from what I said before about that it's going to be amazing and brilliant, and then I'm like, well, it's not going to be utopia. So it's kind of like I needed to put in some kind of disclaimer. You'll know what it is for you when you get to the other side, right? For the now, for where the now is taking us to the next step. And as I said, next step, I'm just confronted here by a pedestrian crossing, and it's showing me, right, that it's black and white, right? You know what the crossing looks like, black and white stripes, the zebra, that's the duality. But they're showing me as I stand here that each white stripe is the next step. So I'm going to cross that now, and now I'm on the first step. It's like a platform, and it's just like the image the angels showed me that I've talked about before. You're shown one step at a time, and that one's illuminated, right? But as we go across that level crossing, we go one step higher in our evolutionary path. So let me know how you've been feeling, what resonates, and when you get to the other side, how that feels, right? And you'll know when you're on that other side. That's all for today. Thanks for listening in, and know you're not alone, and I'm here rooting for you behind the scenes. So don't be afraid to connect. I love connecting with you. Have a beautiful day. Bye.